In this video, I'm going to show you as quickly as possible how to take your brand new Bambu Lab A1 Mini 3D printer all the way from the box to completing your first print. This whole process can be done relatively quickly by most people with no experience, but there are a few short steps to follow with this partly built machine. I'll be covering all of the steps you need to go through, whether you have just the A1 Mini or whether you also have the combo package that includes the AMS light that allows filament changing during a print. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. The very first stage is to clear an area where you can lay everything out first. A tabletop or desk is ideal for this. Take everything out of the box and lay it all out so that you can see what you have. The first thing to do with the A1 Mini is to turn it around and remove the four screws in the plastic Z-axis limiter using the correct Allen key from the supplied toolkit. Once this is done, turn the printer back around and remove the large cable tie holding the protective cardboard and foam around the tool head and remove the protective packaging. Next, remove the foam under the heat bed, then locate the three screws as shown here under the bed. Using the Allen key, turn these screws clockwise until they stop. These lock the heat bed, ready for use. Then it's time to install the purge wiper. This slides in from the back and is held in place with one screw from the bag labeled for purge wiper. After this, find the spool holder base plate and the screws from the bag labeled for spool holder and attach it to the two screws on the back, making sure it's the way round that I'm showing here. The spool holder then simply slides on to attach. If you have the AMS light, then now is the time to assemble it. Start by sitting the AMS body onto the stand and then hold it in place with the four screws from the bag labeled for AMS stand. With all of these four screws tightened, find the spool holders and note the color coding on each one. You should have two yellow and two green. Not surprisingly, the green ones slot onto the shafts with green on the end and the yellow ones match with the yellow shafts. Slot each one into place, giving it a firm push until it clicks home. If any of them don't locate easily, rotate the spool holder until you feel it start to push in. With the AMS light assembled, sit it on the right hand side of your printer and find the four clear tubes that connect the AMS to the printhead. There are two different lengths of tube, the shortest tube attached to ports 1 and 2 on the AMS and the longer ones attached to ports 3 and 4. The tubes simply push into the four connectors on the top of the tool head and then into the receptacles on the AMS. With all of the filament tubes installed, all that's left to do is to plug the AMS cable into the corresponding port on the printer's base. You should now attach your printer's print surface by lining up the back with the locating cutout and then lowering the front. You can now plug in the main power lead and finally switch your printer on. If you're just getting started in 3D printing, then you may not know about our video sponsor, PCBWay. PCBWay are well known for their PCB manufacture, but that's not all they do. PCBWay now have an extensive range of other manufacturing methods, including large-scale 3D printing, CNC machining, laser cutting, and even injection molding. Check out their website from the link in the description below to get a quick free quote and $5 off your first order. Now back to the A1 Mini setup. The first thing to do once your printer fires up is to select your language and region and then put in your Wi-Fi details. Once you've selected your Wi-Fi network and entered your password, your printer will give you the option of adding it to your Bambu account with a QR code. If you don't have an account yet, then it's very easy to set one up with the smartphone app. With the app installed and an account set up, you can then use the app to scan the QR code on the printer's screen, which will then add it to your Bambu account. With the printer added, you can now control it through the app and even watch the camera's feed wherever you go. The next stage with setup, however, is to calibrate the printer, which is all done at the machine and is almost fully automated. All you have to do is hit start and the printer will begin to self-calibrate. Make sure you have the printer sitting where you want it to be when printing, or you'll have to recalibrate if you move it afterwards. The calibration takes approximately 15 minutes and you need to leave it completely alone to run through a series of movements to do some quite clever stuff. The first thing it does is runs through a process called vibration compensation. In basic terms, what it does is puts a range of different movement frequencies through the printer's mechanical components and then listens to see how these components react. Every axis will have its own frequency that it will resonate at, given a chance. So when it finds out each axis frequency, the printer can then compensate to make sure that no print defects are caused. After this, it runs through a process called motor noise cancellation. To do this, each axis is put through a number of repeated movements while sensors listen with the aim of reducing audible noise from the motors. I found this part pretty awesome. You can actually hear the motors getting quieter with each pass until eventually you can't hear anything at all. When it's all finished, you're very nearly ready to print. You may be told that there is an update available at this stage. If there is, let it go ahead. It won't take long. Otherwise, now it's time to load some filament. If you have the AMS, then slot the filament roll onto any one of the spool holders, making sure that the direction of the filament will let it feed into its filament tube. Once the filament is pushed in a little way, the AMS will take over and feed the filament down the tube, ready to be printed with. If you use Bambu Lab filament, then the filament's material and colour will be automatically detected at this stage. If you use another manufacturer's filament, then you'll need to enter those details yourself. To do this, use the printer's screen to select the filament page and then select the reel you want to edit. Press edit and then select the material and colour you've just loaded. If you don't have the AMS, then sit the filament spool onto the external filament spool holder and manually feed the filament down the filament tube until it's just above the tool head. Then use the printer's screen to select the filament page and then the external spool tab. Here you can enter the filament material and colour, but you also need to load the filament from the external spool. When you select load, the printer heats the hot end up and then prompts you to push the filament down the tube at the right time. It then does the rest by purging a bit of filament and then flicking it away using the wiper. Now you're ready to print. I would advise that your first print be one from the included SD card. These files are ready to go with PLA filament, so starting the print is simply a case of selecting print files and then selecting the file you want to print and then next. The printer will then run through a couple of quick checks, then start to print. On the display you'll see an estimated time that the print is going to take and its progress throughout the print. When it's finished, wait a little while for the bed to cool down before trying to remove it. This is for two reasons. Firstly, depending on the material, the bed could be hot enough to hurt until it's cooled down. And secondly, because the print surface is designed to let the print release when it cools, so letting it cool down will make it easier to remove the print. The best way to remove your print is to remove the whole bed and then flex the metal plate in two directions, which will either remove the print or make it much easier to be pulled free. Replace the print surface, being careful to line it up straight again, and you'll be ready to run another print straight away if you want to. If you don't want to print anything else, then you can turn the printer off. However, don't turn the printer off straight away as soon as it's finished printing, as heat soak in the tool head can cause a clog. Give it a few minutes or check the display to see that the hot end has gone below 80 degrees C before turning it off. You are now fully set up and ready to print with your brand new Bambu Lab A1 Mini 3D printer. You're not just limited to printing models on the SD card either. Click over here to see how to use Bambu Studio to find and slice other models ready to use on your brand new printer. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.